In this video lecture, now we will start with a new chapter, electrochemistry. If you look at the word electrochemistry, let's break it up and understand it. Electro, here electro stands for electricity or flow of electrons, and we know that flow of electrons is nothing but electric current, right? So this stands for electricity. And chemistry is, we know, stands or we study chemical reactions in chemistry, right? So electro is electricity and chemistry is chemical reactions. So those chemical reactions that involve electricity, right, come under electrochemistry, right? So chemical reactions that involve electricity, right, there are two types of chemical reactions that mainly we will study in electrochemistry. The first type of chemical reactions that require electricity, right, that need electricity to initiate, to start, right? And the second type of chemical reactions that produce electricity as a result of chemical reaction. When chemical reaction takes place, it will produce electricity. The most common example of such chemical reactions are cells and batteries. In batteries, we know if you plug a bulb, it will glow, right, in the battery. Why? Because there are chemicals in the battery that react to produce electricity, right? So it's the most common example of reaction where electricity is produced as a result of chemical reaction, right? So in the first type of reaction, right, where in the first type of reaction, right here, there are two reactions. First reaction where electricity is required to start or initiate a chemical reaction, right? In this type of chemical reactions, it's chemical energy of chemical reaction that is getting converted into, here electricity, that is electrical energy, is getting converted into chemical energy, right? So here, electrical energy is converted into chemical energy, right? Now in the second type of reactions, where, like cells and batteries, where chemical reaction will take place and electricity is produced. So electricity is produced as a result of chemical reaction, right? So here chemical energy is converted into electrical energy, right? So we say here, if you look at here, interconversion between chemical and electrical energy. Electrochemistry is the study of interconversion between chemical and electrical energy. Electrical energy is converted into chemical energy in first type of reaction. In second type of reactions, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. Now let's take example of first type of reaction. If you remember, in class 10th, we have done electrolysis in detail, right, where we have studied about electrolysis of ionic compounds in aqueous state or in molten state. If you remember, we have done electrolysis of lead bromide in molten state. In molten state, lead bromide contains lead ions and bromide ions. So when electric current was passed, because in that electrolytic reaction, in that electrolytic cell, we have a battery connected, electricity is passed through that battery, right? And we have two electrodes, cathode and anode, right? And the electrolyte contains ions. in molten state or in aqueous state. So when you pass electric current through that battery, these ions will start moving towards their respective electrodes. That is, cations will move towards cathode, anions will move towards anode, right? So in the electrolysis is the example, right? And PbR2, electrolysis of molten lead bromide, right? This will take place in the presence of electric current, and the product of electrolysis would be lead and bromine. Lead will be obtained at cathode and bromine would be obtained at anode, right? So here in molten lead bromide we passed electric current, right? So here electrical energy is used to start this chemical reaction. Chemical reaction was decomposition of lead bromide into lead and bromine gas, right? So electricity has caused this reaction. So we say electrical energy is used, right? And this electrical energy is converted into chemical energy because it has caused this chemical reaction, right? And as we said, we have a battery and we have electrodes, cathode, anode, and electrolyte. So all this arrangement is in a cell, right? We call that cell as electrolytic cell or voltameter, which is an apparatus in which we carry out electrolysis. If you want, you can go through, I have a complete playlist of electrolysis that has all processes of electrolysis explained in detail, right? So even I have electrolysis of lead bromide explained there, right? So you can just check that, and you have that in your 12th class books as well. Electrolysis of sulfuric acid, lead bromide, sodium chloride, right? All these I have already covered in electrolysis in 10th class for ICSE board, right? So electrolysis, this is done in electrolytic cell, or we also call it as voltameter. Right. Now coming to the second type of reactions where electricity, right, is created as a result of chemical reaction. That is, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. So the most common example I have already said is batteries, right? So we would be doing in detail about these reactions where electricity is resulted as due to chemical reaction. That is, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy, right? And this is done in galvanic cell, like we do electrical in this. The arrangement to carry out the first type of reaction is electrolytic cell, and the arrangement to carry out the second type of reaction where chemical energy is converted into electrical energy is your galvanic cell, right? So galvanic cell has all that arrangement where we can convert chemical energy into electrical energy. We can do a chemical reaction that will result into electric current, right? So the most common example of this that we will do in next video lecture would be the second type of reaction is zinc plus copper sulfate will give you zinc sulfate plus copper. This is the reaction, and we have already done this in our previous class also. If you remember, there was an experiment that was done where we took this copper sulfate solution, and this contains copper ions plus sulfate ions, right? And we dipped a zinc rod in it, right? And when we kept this in this situation for some time, we noticed that this zinc rod will start getting thin, right? And the color of the copper sulfate solution will fade as a result of chemical reaction. and this reaction occurred on its own. We haven't supplied any heat energy or any kind of energy to start this chemical reaction, right? So such reaction where we don't supply any energy, right, and they occur on their own, these reactions are known as spontaneous reactions, right? Spontaneous means they take place on their own, they occur itself, right? So what actually happened here is, we have in copper sulfate, we have these copper ions plus sulfate ions in solution, right? And if you remember, we have also studied about activity or reactivity series of metals, right? Where, if you remember, zinc was above copper in the activity series or in the reactivity series. So we know that in the reactivity series, the reactivity decreases as we move down the series, right? So zinc is more reactive than copper, right? So more reactive metal means it will easily lose the outermost electrons, right? So what kind of reaction is taking place here is, zinc will lose two electrons to form Zn2+, right? These electrons lost would be gained by copper ions to form copper metal, right? This is your oxidation reaction and this is your reduction reaction. So reactions where oxidation and reduction take place simultaneously are known as redox reactions, right? And here, as a result of this reaction, you will see that this solution will become hot, right? Why? Because this reaction produced, this will become hot because heat is produced as a result of reaction, right? And this redox reaction where electron got transferred from zinc to copper, this occurred in this single beaker, right? And this heat energy produced, we could not use in any way, right? We could not use this heat energy. It just got wasted in the surroundings, right? And this is a spontaneous reaction, right? So first thing that needs to be kept in mind is, to convert this, we are talking about second kind of reactions where electricity is produced as a result of chemical reactions. Now chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. So these kind of reactions will take place where electricity is produced only in case of electricity is produced only when we have spontaneous reactions taking place. That is, reaction is occurring itself, like this zinc is reacting with copper sulfate to form zinc sulfate and copper, right? And here heat energy is produced. So what we will do is, we will do an arrangement where we will use this chemical energy of this reaction that got converted into heat energy in this reaction when we carried out this in a single beaker. We will make an arrangement where we will carry out these oxidation and reduction reactions in such a way that these electrons, right, that got transferred from zinc to copper, right, would be used to produce electric current, right? So we will be doing this in detail in next video lecture, right? So two things that needs to be kept in mind is electrochemistry, right? Two types of reactions that we would be studying. The first type of reactions are done in electrolytic or voltammeter. The second type of reactions are done using spontaneous reactions, right? Where heat chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. And in this type of reactions, that chemical energy got converted into heat energy, which got wasted in the surroundings, right? And we will do this chemical reaction, the same chemical reaction, in such a way that we will use the chemical energy, or we will use this chemical reaction to produce electric current, right? The electron that you saw that itself transferred from zinc to copper would be used to produce electric current, right? What we would be doing is, instead of carrying out this oxidation and reduction reaction are taking place in the single beaker here. So in order to produce electric current, the arrangement that we will do, right, we will do this oxidation reaction in one beaker, right, and reduction reaction in another beaker, right, and we will connect both the beakers, right, and this electron movement would be used to produce electric current, right. So the arrangement that is used to produce electric current as a result of this chemical reaction, that arrangement is known as galvanic cell, right? Galvanic cell, or we also call it as voltaic cell. Why we call it galvanic or voltaic cell? That is, this is in honor of Luigi Galvani and Alessandro Volta, because they were the first who converted this chemical energy into electrical energy using these kind of arrangements, where we use two beakers, one for oxidation reaction, the other for reduction reaction, right? So we separated the two parts of the reaction, that is oxidation and reduction reaction, physically we are doing oxidation and reduction reaction of this same single reaction in two separate beakers, right? So we'll see this in detail in the coming video lecture, in the next video lecture, right? And just make sure you understood till this point, electrolytic cell, where electrical energy is converted into chemical energy, example electrolysis of lead bromide. Second is galvanic cell, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy using spontaneous redox reaction, very important, by keeping oxidation and reduction parts of reaction physically separated, right? So this part we would be doing in the next lecture. We will see in detail how this galvanic cell works to convert chemical energy into electrical energy. I hope all this is clear to you. Thanks.